Listening Library presents Lord of the Flyfest by Goldy Moldavsky. Read for you by Barrett, Wilbert, Weed. 1. Rafi Francisco really stepped in it this time. She was lost and alone in the middle of a Caribbean jungle, wearing an ill-fitting shirt that clung to all her sweat-filled crevices. There was an incessant bug, big as a bullet, buzzing into her neck, lured there by her ridiculously poor choice of candy-scented body spray. Her backpack seemed to be getting heavier and banged into her lower back with every step she took. She was thirsty and tired and scared, and this colossal mistake of a trip had cost her $2,000, aka her life savings. Yes, Rafi Francisco had definitely stepped in it. But like, literally. She knew the moment she did it, feeling her shoes slide forward on the sticky stuff. Rafi winced as she lifted up her foot to examine the damage. She didn't want to think of the kind of animal that could make such a massive mess. With her luck, it was still close by and watching her through the trees, ready to charge. 30 minutes on this island had already proven soul-crushing and soul, S-O-L-E, crushing. She scraped the bottom of her shoe across the base of the nearest tree trunk until most of the gunk was off. A few hours ago, Rafi had been on an air-conditioned plane eating her third bag of free chips. Now she was here, regretting her life choices. Instinctively, she took her phone out of her pocket, but then remembered there was no service here. There was something so silly about a phone in a jungle, like holding a bouquet of flowers in a blizzard. Like things that belong to two different worlds trying to coexist. And while Rafi had been here only a short while, a lot of things about this place felt off. Rafi had flown to the island of Exuma with a plane full of concertgoers, and then they'd all subsequently boarded a ship that had taken them on a half-hour-long journey here. The island was big enough to take days to explore fully, but still small enough that Rafi couldn't find it on a map. She thought she had once, and studied it long and hard before realizing it was a blueberry muffin crumb. But what was really strange was that when they all got off the ship, there was no one to greet them. Not an organizer, or owner, or even a volunteer, which was how Rafi had ended up in the jungle, looking for anyone who could tell her where to find her luggage. 35 minutes in, and Rafi had the sinking feeling that she and everyone else here had been duped. But the biggest tell was the island itself. It looked nothing like it had in the promo video. Flyfest had gone from rumor to viral fact to the hottest ticket in town in a matter of days, but it really came alive in people's minds when the promo video dropped. Sandy beaches, jet skis, and supermodels. And of course, there was the now legendary voiceover that played over the stunning imagery. Flyfest is a question, an answer, an enigma. A messiah, a sandal. It is all and it is nothing. It will push the limits of boundlessness into an endless quest to enlightened fulfillment you didn't even know you desired, but also never really longed for. It is air. It is foundation. It is sand. It is supermodels. It is the way the sun feels slipping through your fingers and the way water feels blowing out your nostrils. It is standing at the top of Mount Everest and discovering the lost city of El Dorado. It is the Loch Ness Monster. It is the moment right after Mount Vesuvius exploded, but right before the people of Pompeii turned to ash. It is the delicious mix of mental ecstasy and physical ecstasy and synthetic ecstasy. It is yachts, and it is fly. So yeah, things were definitely not as advertised. Silver linings, though. At least no one had seen Rafi step in poop. Hello? A voice called. Rafi turned to find someone rushing toward her, someone about her age with a pageboy haircut and phone in hand. Finally, what is the Wi-Fi password here? Excuse me? Rafi said. You work here, right? In the jungle? No, the festival. Oh, Rafi said, I don't work for the festival. But you're sure? Rafi looked down, Her shirt was neon pink with the hashtag Live Laugh Fly written across the chest in white cursive lettering. When Rafi bought her tickets to Flyfest, she realized she had no idea what the appropriate attire was for a week-long music festival in the Bahamas. Her wardrobe consisted mostly of comfortable sweatshirts in varying shades of gray and taupe. But she wanted to blend in on this trip. She wasn't sure her choice of shirt had worked, though. The moment Rafi set foot on the island and saw what all the other concertgoers looked like, she felt instantly different from them. Her black bob with bangs stood out in a sea of flowing blondes and shimmering browns. Even though they were in the tropics, everyone looked so manicured, not a wisp of hair blowing in the island breeze. While Rafi, in a rush to make it to the airport on time, hadn't put any product in her hair. She hadn't even packed any. Everyone also already looked like they'd made a point to get tanned before showing up, which just made Rafi, who spent probably too much time indoors, feel suddenly Casperish. The pink shirt was the brightest, most carefree, and most expensive t-shirt Rafi owned. When she saw it on the Flyfest website, she figured it'd be perfect. Though, now that she looked at it, she saw it for the generic thing it was and couldn't be 100% certain that the word staff wasn't written across the back. Looking at her new companion's shirt, she noticed a button pinned on the collar with the words they-them on it. I'm Rafi, by the way. She-her. Her introduction was met by a skeptical look that started at the top of Rafi's head and swept slowly down to her offending shoe. Peggy, Yim. Hi, Peggy. I don't work here, by the way. I've actually been looking for someone who does. It's weird, right, that there isn't anyone in charge? She waited for a response, but Peggy was preoccupied with their phone, holding it up to the sky in search of reception. I tried that already, Rafi said. It won't work. I have a satellite phone. I'll get online, Peggy said. It's just a matter of time. You a tech whiz or something? Yes. They offered nothing else, but Rafi liked the short answer, how assured Peggy was when they said it. They were probably one of those STEM coder people who were going to rule the world and knew it. Rafi needed more of that in her life, the boldness, the confidence. She'd come to Flyfest to be bold. Do important things. She suddenly felt bold enough to share something about herself, unprompted. I'm kind of a tech person too. I have a podcast. Rafi paused in case Peggy wanted to ask a follow-up question or maybe murmur their approval. But the only sound that came was the squawk from a toucan flying overhead. Maybe Peggy's silence was their way of telling Rafi to go on. It's called Musical Mysteries. It's about mysteries in, let me guess, Peggy said. Music. Right. I already have one season in the can, 8 episodes. It was pretty successful.
Never heard of it.
Well, successful in the independent podcasting world. It got written up on a few blogs, and Michael Pans called it promising, and he's a contributing sound producer for NPR. So yeah, I'm proud of it. Peggy kept checking their phone. And although they were walking away wordlessly, they also weren't changing the subject, which was new for Rafi, since at this point in the conversation about her podcast, most people usually did. I'm focusing season 2 on Riverstone.
Isn't he supposed to be here?
Yes! The word came out way too loud, but Rafi was just glad for the engagement. This was officially a two-way dialogue now. Her podcast was a topic of interest not only to her, but to Peggy, who was clearly a smart and interesting person. Yes, he's supposed to be one of the musical acts, which is why I'm here.
Stalker?
No, Rafi said, quickening her step to keep up. No, I'm like a journalist. I'm chasing a story. And if I'm right, it could break a lot of things wide open.
The girlfriend disappearance thing?
Yes, Rafi said. She was pleased that even Peggy seemed to acknowledge how that story seemed implausible and strange, which made it perfect for the podcast.
I heard River canceled his trip here.
Rafi stopped walking.
What? All the musicians canceled. The models, too.
Rafi quickened her step to catch up with Peggy, who hadn't stopped walking and pointing their phone at the sky as though beckoning a higher power. But I'm only here to meet River.
Bummer.
Peggy's tone did not in any way convey that this was, in fact, a bummer. Maybe their arm was finally too tired, but Peggy put down their phone, letting it bounce against their hip as they leveled Rafi with a series.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.